Nagelsmann won the first trophy in his career, the German Super Cup with Bayern Munich. Bayern Munich are German Super Cup champions for the 9th time. They defeated Borussia Dortmund. Lewandowski scored in the 14th match in a row for Bayern. Gerd Müller's record is 16 consecutive games with at least one goal scored in each. Juventus have confirmed the signing of 19-year-old Brazilian striker Caio Jorge from Santos. Martin Odegaard is close to making another move from Real Madrid to Arsenal. Negotiations are at an advanced stage. Inter Milan refused to sell Lautaro to Tottenham and Atletico. Bayern players wore special warm-up shirts before the game against Borussia in memory of legendary German striker Gerd Müller. Barcelona midfielder Pedri will get a call-up to the Spanish national team for the September matches. Barca wanted him to take a break, but the young midfielder wants to keep going. Real Madrid are going to extend Valverde's contract in the coming days, according to Fabrizio Romano. Sergio Roberto agreed to accept a salary cut and is going to sign a 2-year deal with Barcelona. Van Gaal commented on his appointment to the Netherlands national team as follows. I would also choose myself. My goal is to become a world champion. Juventus have reached an agreement to sign Manuel Locatelli from Sassuolo on loan that includes a 35 million euros obligation to buy. Barca gives Umtiti 1 week to agree on a move to another club before they terminate his contract. Martin Braithwaite wants to improve his salary. If Barcelona refuses, Martin will ask to cancel his contract. Kane returns to training with the Tottenham squad, Sky Sports reported. Roma have signed Chelsea striker Tammy Abraham for 40 million euros. The English striker signed a 5-year deal. I want to help this team to get to the level where Roma should be, Tammy said. I would like to work abroad. I'm ready to start a new journey, Andrea Pirlo admitted. Bayern introduced the third kit, inspired by the mountain panorama of the Munich surroundings. Insignia declines in its St. Petersburg generous contract offer worth 8 million euros per year, even though Napoli accepted their 30 million euros transfer bid for the Italian winger, according to Sport Italia. Barcelona will focus on extending Pedri and Ansu Fati's contracts on improved terms. The board is going to work on the task once the summer transfer window closes. Pogba has yet to make a decision about his future. He is in no hurry, Daily Mail reported. Fabrizio Romano denies Barcelona's interest in Aubameyang. Pjanic's return to Turin is still possible. Juve have to sell Ramsey to make that happen. Andrew Robertson returns to the Liverpool squad as he successfully recovered after an ankle injury. Solskjaer wants the board to sign new contracts with the Man United leaders Shaw, Maguire, Bruno, Rashford and Pogba. Tottenham are interested in signing Chelsea's Kurzawa, according to Sky Sports. Milan continues to negotiate with Chelsea on Bakayoko. Any deal works for the Italian club, whether it's a loan or a full transfer deal. Yusuf Demir's dribbling style is similar to Messi's, Gerard Pique said while streaming on Twitch. During the Barcelona-Real Sociedad match broadcast, the TV crew messed up, showing Braithwaite's top speed reached 121.1 km per hour. Barca are going to resolve the questions with Busquets and Alba's salary reductions in the coming days, Rock One reports. Manchester City will make one last attempt to get Harry Kane before August 31st. Inter Milan striker Lautaro Martinez is currently the most expensive and valuable player in Serie A. According to a report from Transfermarkt, his actual transfer price is $88 million. Bayern Munich defeated Borussia Dortmund in 6 consecutive games. This is the first time in the history of Der Klassiker. Inter Milan could sign Borussia Mönchengladbach striker Marcus Thuram, as the Marzio reported. Wolfsburg have appealed their expulsion from the German Cup. The club somehow made 6 substitutions instead of 5 in that game.
Cristiano Ronaldo's telling response to Raphael Varane's Man Utd arrival. Manchester United was finally able to unveil Raphael Varane as a Red Devil as their long pursuit for the Real Madrid centre-back finally reached its conclusion. Cristiano Ronaldo has given his seal of approval to Raphael Varane's move to Manchester United. The World Cup-winning centre-back was finally unveiled as a Red Devil this weekend, paraded on the pitch before his new team's Premier League opener against Leeds. A deal had been agreed between United and Real Madrid for weeks, but a number of issues held up the official announcement. But those were finally ironed out at the end of last week, with Varane signing a 4-year deal at Old Trafford. His arrival on the pitch set the tone for an atmosphere that helped inspire Ole Gunnar Solskjaer's side to a thumping 5-1 win over rivals Leeds. Legendary United defender Rio Ferdinand was on the pitch to greet Varane, shaking his hand, wishing him luck, and telling him to win, win, win. Ferdinand posted the exchange on social media and Ronaldo was quick to respond, posting simply, "Grande, great." Ronaldo played alongside Varane almost 200 times and predicted he would become one of the best in the world when he was just 19. Varane is now learning a lot. "He has grown as a player and as a man," Ronaldo told us back in 2013. "He is quick, he has good composure and he is very calm. He is accumulating experience at his young age. He is humble and, for me, in a few years will be one of the best central defenders in the world. I have no doubt about it." Solskjaer offered a similarly glowing assessment of his newest recruit while hoping that his prolific trophy record will translate to the rest of the squad. Solskjaer told the club's official site, "I'm absolutely delighted that we have managed to secure one of the best defenders in the world over the last 10 years. Raphael is a proven winner who we have tracked over a long period of time and we know just how much of a dedicated professional he is. We have a great depth of international defenders and he will add his immense skill set and leadership to that group. He is a unique defender with a rare combination of top-level attributes that I know will rub off on our younger players. He has won everything there is to win, but I know that he is still determined to succeed. I can't wait to welcome him into the squad." Varane added, "Manchester United is one of the most iconic clubs in world football and the chance to come here and play in the Premier League is something I couldn't turn down. There is a lot more that I want to achieve in my career and I know I'm joining a squad full of great players who will all have the same determination to win matches and trophies."